Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today I am filming a very special video for all of you, and in this video I'm going to be recommending some books. So yeah, let's get into it. My recommendations are going to be centered around YA romance. I know that I like a little bit of romance, and hopefully you like a little bit of romance because you clicked on this video, and I feel like there is a lot of good YA romance out there, and I thought I would just share some of my favorites with all of you. The first YA romance I'm going to be talking to you about is kind of one of the books that really got me into reading, and that is Meg Cabot's The Princess Diaries. I used to love this series as a child, and even though she's a princess, it's still totally relatable and just so good. And I loved Mia and Michael. Meg Cabot is a fantastic author, and I love her writing style. I have another book by Meg Cabot, and this book has stuck with me for years after I've read it, and not a lot of people talk about it. And it is Meg Cabot's Ready or Not. This is the second book in her All-American Girl series. And basically it's about this girl who saves the president's life and all of the chaos that happens once she starts dating the president's son. I think she can take some really heavy topics and make them really light and easy to read about, but still maintaining that core of importance that those topics deserve. Moving on to more recent books, those ones are kind of a little bit older. This is a book I just recently read and I'm obsessed with it, and it is Anne and the French Kiss by Stephanie Perkins. Everybody loves Stephanie Perkins because Stephanie Perkins is an amazing writer. This is a story about a young girl who moves to Paris to go to a boarding school, and she meets a very attractive boy named Etienne St. Clair, and it's all about how their relationship starts off as friends and then it develops into something more. Their relationship is it's so good. They just have this really witty and sarcastic way of talking to each other. The next book I'm going to talk about is definitely romantic, but it's also a little bit sad, and it is John Green's The Fault in Our Stars. It's about a young cancer patient named Hazel Grace Lancaster who falls in love with the ever-charming Augustus Waters. John Green has this way of writing that is poetic without being pretentious. Okay, sometimes it gets a little bit pretentious, but it's like just enough that it's just real good. Augustus and Hazel are incredibly intelligent, incredibly smart, but they still feel like teenagers. There's so many lines in this book that are so quotable and so poignant and just book I'm going to talk about is another one of my favorite books, and it is Eleanor and Park by Rainbow Rowell. Eleanor and Park is about a young boy named Park and meets the new girl named Eleanor. They sit together on the bus and their love kind of develops through their shared interest in music and comic books. Eleanor and Park are both such unique characters. Park is half Korean. It's not something that you see a lot in media. Normally a lot of Asian men are depicted as like asexual or as like weak and not desirable. It's really nice to see that little bit of diversity, and you feel like you're transported to this small town. Unlike all of the books that I've talked about or will talk about in this video, you see their relationship progress from both of their perspectives. I feel like that makes a love story stronger because a love story is about these two people coming together, and a lot of times, especially in YA, you don't get to see that. Eleanor and Park, love it. Love it so much. So last but not least, To All the Boys I've Loved Before by Jenny Han. I started reading this because Reagan from Peru's Projects is always talking about Jenny Han, about how good she is, and I'm here to say that she's right, because I started reading this book with not super high expectations. There are moments that are cheesy and sweet and adorable and awkward and quirky, but nothing ever feels like overdone. And I just loved it so much. I loved Laura Jean's family. I just thought watching them interact together was just so beautiful and real. Again, to talk about diversity, Laura Jean is half Korean, and so Jenny Han brings a lot of that Korean influence into their family. Those subtle things that makes it feel like this is an actual family, this is an actual girl. And I'm currently reading the sequel to this book, P.S. I Still Love You, and I'm just as in love with Laura Jean as I am, and I character. Don't know if there's gonna be a third book, but if there was, it's an instant buy. Like, I'm at the point where now I need to run out and go buy Jenny Han's The Summer I Turned Pretty trilogy, because I just need more Jenny Han in my life. Like, it's a fact. And yeah, so those are all of my YA romance recommendations. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope some of these books you haven't read before and that you'll go and check out. If you've read any of these, please let me know what you thought in the comments below. I shall see you tomorrow. Bye!